of understanding.
A spirit of counsel and of strength.
A spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord.
And his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. For a child is born to us, a son is given us.
Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor.
God Hero.
Father Forever.
Prince of Peace.
His dominion is vast and forever peaceful from David's throne.
Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion.
Shout, daughter of Jerusalem.
See, your king comes to you.
Righteous and having salvation.
Gentle and riding on a donkey. He will proclaim peace to the nations.
Hosanna, Hosanna, the highest. Spent to save. tell you where you cannot follow me now. Later on, you shall come after me.
Lord, why can I not follow you now? At your side, I am prepared to face imprisonment and death itself.
I tell you, Peter, the cock will not crow today before you have three times the soul with me.
Even if I have to die with you, I will not disown you.
Abba, Father, if it's possible, let this cup pass me by. Still, let it be as you would have it, not as I. Asleep, Simon, so you could not stay awake with me for even an hour? Be on guard, and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but nature is weak.
Watch and pray. Stay here and keep watch with me. Watch and pray.
Father! If this cup cannot pass me by without my drinking from it, your will be done.
Peace, Rabbi.
Judas, would you betray the Son of Man with a kiss?
There he is! Get him!
Stay there!
Don't
let him get away! Help him! Help him! Hold him tight!
Let my sword defend you!
From day to day,
I sat teaching in the temple precincts. Yet you never arrested me. Nonetheless, all this has happened in fulfillment of the writings of the prophets. This is your hour, the triumph of darkness.
This man has declared I can destroy God's temple and rebuild it in 3 days.
I've heard such a thing.
Have you no answer to the testimony leveled against you?
Nothing.
He says nothing.
Silence.
I order you under oath before the living God to tell us whether you are the Messiah, the Son of God.
It is you who say. But I tell you this, soon you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming on the clouds of heaven.
Blasphemy! Blasphemy! What further need have we of witnesses? Remember, you heard the blasphemy. What is your verdict?
Guilty.
He deserves death.
Away with him! Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him! The blasphemy must be silenced! The blasphemer must die!
Take him to Pilate for sentencing.
I have sinned! I've done wrong to deliver up an innocent man!
What's that to us? That's your affair.
What am I? That I could sell my beloved friend and master to his enemies!
You are weak.
You are weak, but his love for you is strong.
Love for me? But I sold him to a certain terrible death.
The Son of Humanity will gladly die for your weakness.
How could he gladly die for your weakness? You're fooling yourself.
Why is it so difficult for you to believe that he loves you?
No, I want to believe, but I'm afraid. If I let myself believe, I'll open up my heart to receive his love. But if I find that I'm wrong, that he has no more love left for me, then...
That would bring you even more pain than you already suffer from now.
Yes!
Judas, lay your suffering in his heart.
Keep your suffering to yourself.
You must have faith that his love is real.
No! I can't risk it.
But you are keeping yourself away from his love with your lack of faith.
Better I keep myself away from his love than he might keep his love away from me.
Thank you.
it, which I'm sure he will. Pilate would sell his own mother as a slave before making a popular decision.
Shh, your saucy tongue will get us both in trouble. Hey, I've seen you before. You were with that man, Jesus, from Galilee.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're lying. You were with that man, Jesus, we've been speaking of.
I don't even know the man.
There's no use lying. We can tell you're one of his disciples by your Galilean accent.
I swear to you, I don't even know this fellow that you're talking about.
Before the cock crows, you will deny me three times!
Yesterday. King, or messiah, or emperor, or what have you, well, we'd have no time to do anything else.
King Herod is very anxious this criminal Jesus be executed.
He is. I thought he just wanted him to be, let's say, punished by the whip.
Word is all over Jerusalem that King Herod will smile very favorably upon the person who rids him, once and for all, of this Nazarene Jesus. That person could be you, Pilate.
I see. Well, that does put a new twist on things. Look here, I'm a busy man. Are you going to defend yourself? And now my wife tells me she believes this Jesus to be innocent because she's had a dream. A dream. But I just do not know what to do. Any action I take will be looked upon disfavorably by somebody. King Herod, my wife, Roman law, they're all at odds and I'm in the middle. Oh, if only I didn't have to decide this man's fate.
Kill the Nazarene!
Ugh, another demonstration.
Death to Jesus!
Death to Jesus!
Wait. What are they saying?
Kill the Nazarene!
Death to Jesus!
What are you waiting for?
That's it! I'll have the crowd decide the fate of this Jesus fellow. That way, I can wash my hands of personal responsibility for whatever outcome.
Kill the Nazarene!
Death to Jesus!
What are you waiting for?
Kill the Nazarene!
Death to Jesus!
What are you waiting for?
Kill the Nazarene!
Death to Jesus! What are you waiting for?
Under Roman law, I can release one prisoner to you this day. Now, which prisoner shall I release to you? Barabbas or Jesus, the so-called Messiah?
Barabbas!
Free Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
Barabbas! Barabbas! Barabbas!
And what shall I do with Jesus?
Crucify him!
Put him to death!
Nail him to the cross!
Crucifixion!
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 Done! But take note! I am innocent of this man's blood! The responsibility is yours! Guards! Prepare this man for crucifixion!
Look at him. Take my mother home. my mother hold.
I'll die so easy if you please take my mother home.
Children. be counted fortunate indeed. It will beg the mountains that follow them and crush them, and the hills that bury them. Such things as these are done to me, the living tree. What will they do to you?
You! Come here! What's your name?
Simon of Cyrene.
Well, Simon of Cyrene. Carry the cross for this fellow, so we can get to Golgotha sometime in the next year. I have things to do this evening.
To tell you the truth, I really don't want to carry this cross. If I didn't think that the Roman guards would beat me, I would refuse to carry it too. It's not that I'm a mean-spirited fella. It's just that I don't know this condemned man. And besides, I have plenty of troubles on my own weighing me down. I don't need this man's burden too. It was with a heavy, grudging heart that I lifted up this cross. But then, the strangest thing happened to me, and I don't quite know how to put it into words. As I felt the weight of the cross bearing down on my back, the heaviness in my heart, it lifted up and disappeared. Friend, if serving you can make my burden light, I gladly offer up my strong back to help you. I don't feel like I'm carrying this cross. I feel like this cross is carrying me.
Our salvation.
He's quite clever in saving others, but he can't save himself.
Like a lamb led to slaughter, or a sheep before the shearers, he was silent and opened not his mouth.
He trusted God. Let God show his approval by delivering him.
Oppressed and condemned, he was taken away. And who would have thought any more of his destiny?
Get back to your people. You're in the way.
His face.
Let me hold your veil a moment. If only I had had the courage to ease his pain, then my veil would have touched his face and taken up his precious blood.
Tearing at the flesh of a fallen man.
reducing the person Jesus to the same fragile nakedness he was when Mary bore him into the world.
Reducing him to the same innocent nakedness of Adam and Eve in the garden. But the fully clothed vultures hovering around Jesus find no beauty in his nakedness. They despise it.
It reminds them of their own vulnerable selves, which they carefully clothe against any hurt,
any challenge,
any love.
Finished ripping at their heel, the vultures leave the sinless flesh of Jesus to be given up in sacrifice for all the fragile, fallen people of the earth.
Now, which one of you is going to nail him down? No one? Anyone here experienced at driving down nails? Wonderful. A bunch of fools who don't know what they're doing, and I'm in a hurry. You do it. Now listen carefully to my instructions. I only plan on telling you once. I'm gonna start with the hands first. Make sure you center the nail right here in his hands. Once you've nailed the hands, you move to the feet. Cross one foot over the other, just like that. Make sure the knees are bent so the feet are flat against the wood. Got it? Place the nail right here, in his feet. Oh, and make sure you hold him down with all your weight. He's gonna be jerking around a lot. Makes it hard to drive the nail down. Now get to work!
My God, why have you come to end?
Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do.
Forgive them? This man looks upon his executioners, and he asks his God to forgive them? I would never ask God to forgive my executioners. I'd curse them. I'd ask God to send them to a place of unbearable torture, never-ending suffering, eternal damnation. Now, there'd be no forgiveness for my dying lips. And there'd be no making excuses for the actions of my enemies, no suggesting that they do not know what they are doing. Of course we know what we're doing. We're crucifying a man who is... A man whose crime is... A man who is guilty of... We are crucifying a man who's too good to be guilty of any crime. Why are we killing an innocent man? And what kind of man is he to forgive us? Truly, this man is the Son of God.
Woman, behold your son. Son, behold your mother.
How can this be? I can love no son but you.
I can never replace you in your mother's heart, Lord. She will resent me for even trying.
How can this be? How many times have I asked that question? Why must I still ask it?
Help me, Lord. Help me know what words will comfort her.
How can this be? I am with child, yet no man has touched me.
You have been touched by the Holy Spirit, Mary, so that you may bear a child called Emmanuel.
I am only a poor girl, yet I have given birth to a babe whose night candle is a shining star, his lullaby a choir of angels, proclaiming him the Prince of Peace.
You may be poor, Mary, but you're rich in faith. That's why God has picked you to be the favored woman, to give birth to the Prince of Light.
How can this be? My son is being whipped, taunted, crowned with thorns. My son deserves a crown of gold, not thorns.
But his crown, it will rule over a kingdom far greater than any ruled over by a crown of gold.
He is being crucified when he should be honored as a king.
But in time to come, the nations, they will be on bended knee before his cross. He will be called the King of Kings.
The last request my beloved son makes of me.
son will not be forgotten.
My God! My God! Why have you forsaken me? It is finished. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit.
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Live on in my love. All this I tell you, that my joy may be yours, and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. No greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends.
Thank you.
Times I denied knowing my lord. Words of denial rolling so easily out of my mouth that I almost believed my own lie. I almost convinced myself that I'd never been in my lord's loving presence. And then, all of a sudden, there he was, standing before me, looking into my eyes. I could say nothing, hoping my silence would hide my weakness. Foolish hope. He knew. He looked into my eyes. He looked into my heart. He looked into my soul. He knew everything about me. And then, fear kept me silent. Fear I would learn that, seeing my weakness, he would no longer love me. He looked into my eyes, he looked into my heart, he looked into my soul, and everything about that look told me that he still loved me. He completely loved me. He loved me in my weakest hour. Oh, foolish fear! My heart was full of words, but I could say nothing. And then he was gone. Carried away from me by his own destiny, never to hear me speak the words that I held in my heart.
Thank you. As she told us where she'd been, she said they moved him in the night, and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away, and now his body isn't there. Circumstance and speculation couldn't lift me very high, 'cause I'd seen them crucify him. Then I saw him die. Just melted into
Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. Receive the Holy Spirit. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. If you forgive each other's sins, they are forgiven. If you hold them bound, they are held bound. Teach them to carry out everything I have commanded you, and know that I am with you always, until the end of time.
No more will the sun give you daylight, nor moonlight shine on.